one who accepts repentance, one who accepts repentance and he forgives the sins, and he does not, it is not something difficult for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the author mentioned an example of this in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ in a hadith narrated by Sahih Muslim from Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, that the Messenger of Allah ﷺ said what he narrated from his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَذْنَبَ عَبْدٌ ذَنْبًا فَقَالَ اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِي ذَنْبِي فَقَالَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى أَذْنَبَ عَبْدِي ذَنْبًا فَعَلِمَ أَنَّ لَهُ رَبًّا يَغْفِرُ الذَّنْبَ وَيَأْخُذُ بِهِ ثُمَّ عَادَ فَأَذْنَبَ. So he gives the example of a human being, and he did a sin, and then after he did that sin, he said, "Oh Allah, forgive me for my sin." So then Allah responds and he says that my servant did a sin, and he knows he has a Lord that forgives sins but also can punish for them. And then the servant, after he made that repentance, ثُمَّ عَادَ فَأَذْنَبَ, he returned to that sin. فَقَالَ أَيْ رَبْ اِغْفِرْ لِي ذَنْبِي فَقَالَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى عَبْدِي أَذْنَبَ ذَنْبًا فَعَلِمَ أَنَّ لَهُ رَبًّا يَغْفِرُ الذَّنْبَ وَيَأْخُذُ بِهِ. Allah says the same, that my servant has committed a sin and he asked for forgiveness, and he knows that he has a Lord that forgives sins, and also he holds people accountable to them. ثُمَّ عَادَ فَأَذْنَبَ, and then the third time this servant returned to the sin, and then after that he says, "Oh my Lord, forgive my sin." And then Allah, he says, my servant has committed a sin, and he knows that he has a Lord who forgives sins and holds people accountable by them. اِعْمَلْ مَا شِئْتَ فَقَدْ غَفَرْتُ لَكَ, Allah says, do whatever you want, I have forgiven you. And then the author will explain, the scholars explain, what does that mean if Allah says that, do whatever you wish, I have forgiven you. He says that, مَا دُمْتَ تُذْنِبُ وَتَتُوبَ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا فَإِنِّي أَغْفِرُ لَكَ عَلَى مَا كَانَ مِنْكَ وَلَا أُبَالِي بِكَثْرَةِ ذُنُوبِكَ. It's as if Allah is saying that as long as you sin and repent from it with a sincere repentance, then I will forgive you whatever you have done, and I will not care by the number of your sins. وَذَلِكَ لِأَنَّهُ هُوَ التَّوَّابُ الَّذِي يَهِبُ التَّوْبَةَ وَيَقْبِلُهَا مِمَّنْ وَهَبَهَا لَهُ. And then he says that is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the acceptor of repentance, who actually gifts us repentance in the first place. It is a gift from Allah to repent and seek His forgiveness. And then He accepts it from us. So the author says, وَهَبَهَا لَهُ, He gifted it to him, إِذَا الْفَضْلُ مِنْهُ إِلَيْهِ. Because bounty, it starts with Allah and it returns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the first one to give it, and then when we use it in the obedience of Allah, it returns to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَالْعَبْدُ إِذَا أَرَادَ أَنْ يَتُوبَ فَلْيَسْأَلِ اللَّهَ أَنْ يُوَفِّقَهُ لِلْتَوْبَةِ. When the servant wishes to repent to Allah, then let him ask Allah, أَنْ يُوَفِّقَهُ لِلْتَوْبَةِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him the tawfiq and ability to make tawbah. فَإِنَّهَا أَوَّلُ الطَّرِيقِ إِلَيْهِ وَوَسَطُهُ وَآخِرُهُ. Because Tawbah is the beginning of the path to Allah. It is the middle of the path and it is the end of the path. وَهِيَ الشَّفَرَةُ الَّتِي بِهَا تُحَلُّ رُمُوزُ الْمَعْرِفَةُ وَتُعْرَفُ بِهَا الْمَعَالِمُ وَالْحُدُودُ. It is a metaphor, he says, Tawbah is like, you know, the blade or the knife, that it makes it lawful for us now to have the ma'rifah of Allah and to know the limits and prohibitions in His religion. وَبِهَا يَتَخَطَّ التَّائِبُونَ الْعَقَبَاتِ الْكَأُودِ. And from Tawbah, the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who repent to Him can avoid dangerous, you know, we can say potholes or hurdles on the way. الَّتِي يَضَعَهَا الشَّيْطَانُ فِي طَرِيقِ السَّالِكِينَ, that shaitan has placed in the path of those who are seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يقول الله عز وجل في شأن المخلفين الثلاثة الذين تخلفوا عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في غزوة تبوك وجاءوا تائبين. Allah mentions in Surah At-Tawbah, there's a whole surah in Quran mentioning Surah At-Tawbah, and it gets its name from the story of the three companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, who were companions who accompanied him in all of his expeditions except غزوة تبوك, in the final expedition of the Prophet to Tabuk. They are Hilal ibn Umayyah, Malik ibn Ka'b ibn Malik, Hilal ibn Umayyah, and Murarat ibn Rabi'ah, I believe. I think I got his name mixed up. But there are three companions who were senior companions and they didn't have a justified excuse to stay back from the expedition. As Allah described it, لَقَدْ تَابَ اللَّهُ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ الَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُ فِي سَاعَةِ الْعُسْرَةِ. It was a very difficult time. It was very hot. It was a very difficult time in the financial situation of Medina. The companions, they had a delay in their crops for 1 year. They took a loan and they were waiting for their crops the second year. And they were told to leave at that time. So anyway, it was a difficult time. And then Allah in the end, he said, وعلى الثلاثة الذين خلفوا حتى إذا ضاقت عليهم الأرض بما رحبت وضاقت عليهم أنفسهم وظنوا أن لا ملجأ من الله إلا إليه ثم تاب عليهم ليتوبوا. These companions, they were boycotted for 50 days. Nobody could make salam to them. Allah, he said, ثم تاب عليهم ليتوبوا. That Allah turned to them or gave them the ability to make tawbah so he could accept it from them. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the author, he says, فَقَدْ سَبَقَهُمْ بِرَحْمَتِهِ فَوَفَّقَهُمْ لِلتَّوْبَةِ فَأَدُّوهَا كَمَا تَلَقَّوْهَا. He said that he initiated his mercy to them and gave them the ability to make tawbah, so they fulfilled it as they should have fulfilled it. وَهَذَا مَا يُشِرُ إِلَيْهِ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى. And this is an example of what Allah says in verse 25 of Surah 42, Surah Ash-Shura. وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ عَنْ عِبَادِهِ وَيَعْفُو عَنِ السَّيِّئَاتِ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Allah is the one who accepts the repentance from His servants and He pardons their sins and He knows all they do. So the author, he mentions one of the secrets in the word عَن. عَن is a harf. Is a participle, and it doesn't have meaning in itself. It only has meaning when you combine it with another word. So Allah, He said, He accepts tawbah an ibadi. He does not say min ibadi. Why? Because لأنها منه أتت وعنهم قبلت. Because tawbah, it has been committed by them. They have done that tawbah, and it is accepted from them. It is accepted from them. And then he mentions some couplets of the Prophet ﷺ is attributed. I thought it was Abdullah ibn Rawaha who said it in the Ghazwa of Al-Ahzab. Walawlallahu mahtadayna. We swear by Allah, or if it were not by Allah, we would never be guided. Wala tasaddaqna, wala sallayna. Nor would we have ever given charity, nor prayed. فَأَنزِلَ السَّكِينَةَ عَلَيْنَا. So, O Allah, please send sakina, tranquility upon us. وَثَبِّتِ الْأَقْدَامَ لِمَنْ لَاقِينَ. And make our feet firm for those that we meet in battle. Okay. الرُّكْنَ الْخَامِسِ. The fifth and last pillar, thank you for being patient with me. The fifth and last pillar of Tawbah al-Nasuh is هو رد المظالم إلى أصحابها أو التخلص منها بطلب التجاوز عنها منهم. Is as if we have done a sin that is between us and Allah, then we have to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are some rights that are shared between the creation, حقوق العباد. And there is a court for that Allah will judge for on the Day of Judgment. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, من كان له مظلمة عند أخيه فليتحلل منه اليوم قبل أن لا يكون دينار ولا درهم. That whoever has a grievance with their brother in this world or any other human in this world, then they should seek pardon and make it right in this world, because before a day comes on the Day of Judgment, there is no gold, there is no silver, there is no dinar ولا درهم. So now the author is mentioning, what do we do if we have usurped the right of another person? We took something that was theirs, or we didn't give them what they were due. And I hope in a few weeks, inshallah, we'll read more about this in a different book. He said to return the grievance or the to the person who is rightful of it, or to seek pardon from the wrong that we have done them. فَإِن لَمْ يَسْتَطِعِ التَّائِبُ أَن يَرُدَّ هَذِهِ الْحُقُوقَ لِأَصْحَابِهَا. If the repenting person does not have the ability to return the rights to the person Maybe too much time has passed. Maybe something happened to that thing they took. وعجز عن طلب التجاوز عنها لأي سبب من الأسباب الجلية أو الخفية فليطلب من الله أن يرضي عنه خصومه يوم القيامة. Then and the person is unable to make it right, to return that right to that person for whatever reason it may be, big or small, then they should ask Allah to make that person they wrong pleased with them on the day of judgment. And there's some hadith, there's a dua the Prophet used to pray, Allah minni basharun aw abdu min ibadik fa ayyuma muslimin adaytuhu aw jaradtuhu aw la'antuhu aw shatamtuhu faj'al dhalika qurbatan aw tuqribuha biha ilayka min qiyam. That, oh Allah, I'm a human like any other human, I get mad, I get angry. So for any believer that I have insulted or accidentally lashed or I cursed, then make that a means of him being closer to you. Give him reward for that. So Allahu A'lam if this is an example, but it just comes to mind. If we are unable to return the right of the person, then we hope on the day of judgment they will forgive us. وهذه الأركان الخمسة التي ذكرناها هنا لها شروط وضوابط يضيق المقام عن شرحها وفيما ذكرناه كفاية. Author says that these five pillars we have mentioned, that they have conditions and point and much details, that it is very difficult to cover all in this, you know, place, because his book is about the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not necessarily a book on fiqh or a tazkiyah. But he says, وَعَلِينَ أَنْ نُجَدِّدَ التَّوْبَ مَعَ اللَّهِ فِي كُلِّ وَقْتٍ دُونَ أَنْ يُدَخِلَنَا شُعُورَ بِالْيَأْسِ فَإِنَ الْيَأْسِ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ كُفْرٌ. He finishes his chapter and he says, it is binding upon us to renew our tawbah to Allah in every, you know, moment, دُونَ أَنْ يُدَخِلَنَا شُعُورَ بِالْيَأْسِ, so that we should not feel despair or despondent of the mercy of Allah. فَإِنَّ الْيَأْسَ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ كُفْرٌ, because despairing of the mercy of Allah is disbelief. And then the proof of that is the ayah in Surah Yusuf, where it is the wording of Sayyidina Ya'qub alayhi salam. He is a very unique prophet alayhi salam, where Allah, he says, وَإِنَّهُ لَذُو عِلْمٍ لِمَا عَلَّمْنَاهُ, he was the possessor of great knowledge that Allah gave him. And some scholars mention about this, like Abu Hassan Ali Nadwi rahimahullah, then every time Ya'qub alayhi salam spoke to his sons, he mentioned some sifa, some name of Allah, some action of Allah. He had great knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the prophets did, but Allah chose him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So anyway, what he told his sons when they were separated from Benjamin, their brother Benjamin, and Ya'qub was now separated from two of his beloved sons, Yusuf and Benjamin. So he told them that اِذْهَبُوا فَتَحَسَّسُوا مِنْ يُوسُفُ أَخِي, that go and see if you can find any trace or any, you know, thing that will lead us to Yusuf and his brother Benjamin, because they had a different mother than the other 10 brothers of Allah. وَلَا تَيْأَسُوا مِنْ رُوحِ اللَّهِ, and never despair in the mercy of Allah. إِنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُوا مِنْ رُوحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. He said the only people that despair in the mercy of Allah are the disbelievers. And then Allah mentions of Surah Al-Hijr of Ibrahim alayhi salam's word, وَمَنْ يَقَنَطُ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّهِ إِلَّا الضَّالُونَ, he told the angels that came from that came to Ibrahim to give him the good news of he and his wife Sarah will have a son Ishaq, and then they were going to destroy the people of Lut. So they said that the people told him that the angels, they said that in Surah Al-Hijr, the ayah, Ibrahim alayhi salam was told that قال فما خطبكم أيها المرسلون, this sort of that. I can't remember the ayah right now, may Allah forgive me. But anyway, they told him, like, do not be fearful. So the Ibrahim alayhi salam, he responded, he said, وَمَنْ يَقْنَطُ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّهِ لَلضَّالُّونَ. Who will despair from the mercy of their Lord except the misguided people? And then the author, he says, وَنَذْكُرُ دَائِمًا قَوْلُ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكُ وَتَعَالَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ سُوءًا أَوْ يَظْلِمْ نَفْسَهُ ثُمَّ يَسْتَغْفِرِ اللَّهَ يَجِدِ اللَّهَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. Whoever does wrong or oppresses themselves, whoever does bad or evil and wrong themselves, ثُمَّ يَسْتَغْفِرِ اللَّهَ, and then they seek the forgiveness of Allah, يَجِدِ اللَّهَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا, they will find Allah the most forgiving, the most merciful. This is in Surah Nisa, verse 110. So this, and then he says, وَنَدْعُ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَ فِي صَبَاحِنَا وَمَسَائِنَا بِدُعَى النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الَّذِي رَوَاهُ الْبُخَارِي وَمُسْلِمٌ عَنْ أَبِي مُوسَى الْأَشْعَرِي. And he says, we should remember this dua of the Prophet, peace be upon him, in our mornings, in our evenings, as mentioned in Sahihain by Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, that the Prophet said, Allahumma ghfir li khati'ati wa jahli. Oh Allah, forgive me my mistakes, my ignorance, wa israfi fi amri, and my exceeding the limits or exceeding the bounds. Allah's religion has limits. If we go outside of those limits, it is not lawful for us. Wa ma anta a'lamu bihi minni, and that which you know from my sins more than I. Allahumma ghfir li khati'ati wa amdi. Allahumma ighfir li khata'i wa 'amdi. Oh Allah, forgive me those sins I did accidentally and those that I did intentionally. Wa hazli wa jiddi. And this is another expression. I wish my Arabic was good enough to show the difference between serious and mistaken. Wa kullu dhalika 'indi. And all the sins that I have done. Allahumma ighfir li ma qaddamtu wa ma akhartu. Oh Allah, forgive me the sins I did in the past and also save me from committing sins in the future. وَمَا أَسْرَرْتُ وَمَا أَعْلَنْتُ, and those sins that I did in private and I did in public. أَنْتَ الْمُقَدِّمُ أَنْتَ الْمُؤَخِّرُ, you are the ones that bring things near, or you are the ones that delay them. You bring them closer or you bring them further. وَأَنْتَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ, and Allah, you are capable of all things. This concludes our class. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst the tawabin. May Allah accept our repentance. May Allah forgive us. And may Allah give us all that is good in this world. Wa sallallahu ta'ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.